हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू सिविल रेफरेंस पॉइंट। आप असिस्टेंट टाउन प्लानर एग्ज़ाम की प्रिपरेशन कर रहे हो और आपने इस चैनल को अभी तक सब्सक्राइब करके बेल आइकन नहीं दबाया है तो जल्दी से कर लो। हम आपके लिए असिस्टेंट टाउन प्लानर एग्ज़ाम से रिलेटेड इम्पोर्टेंस टॉपिक के ऊपर मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट MCQs की वीडियो प्लेलिस्ट लेके आए हैं। अगर इस वीडियो से आपको एक भी मार्क्स ज़्यादा आया तो वो आपके मेरिट लिस्ट को ऊपर लाने के लिए बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट रहने वाला है। हम आपके लिए फ्री मॉक टेस्ट भी जल्दी से शेड्यूल करने वाले। आप अगर इंटरेस्टेड हो तो हमारे टेलीग्राम ग्रुप पे ज्वाइन हो सकते हो, लिंक डिस्क्रिप्शन में अवेलेबल है। तो चलिए देखते हैं आज की क्वेश्चन। सो आवर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, एज पर द नेशनल बिल्डिंग कोड 2005, the minimum size of a habitable room in square meter is, and the options are A 9.5 square meter, B 10.5 square meter, C 12.5 square meter, and option D is 14.5 square meter. And the right answer for this question number 1 is option number A, that is 9.5 square meter. So next question, question number 2, the scheme in which additional FSI is provided to the owner of the plot in lieu of the land acquired, which can be used elsewhere, is called, and the options are A guided urban development, B transfer of development rights, option C eco mark scheme, and option D is inclusionary scheme. And the right answer for this question number 2 is option number 2, that is transfer of development rights. So the next question, question number 3, area of a plot is 800 square meter, the maximum permissible FAR is 150 and the maximum ground coverage is 50%. Utilizing full permissible ground coverage and assuming all floors of the same area, how many stories can be built on the plot? So we have to find out how many stories can built on that plot. So options A 3, B 4 stories, C option 6 stories, and D option is 8 story building. So right answer for this question is option A, that is 3 stories we can build on that plot. So next question, question number 4, in Maharashtra, for a special township project spread over more than 200 hectares, permissible FSI for saleable residential plot is, and the options are 1.0, B 1.5, C 1.6, and option D is 1.7. So right answer for this question is option number D, that is 1.7. Then next question number 5, the minimum requirement of the continuous land excluding forest, river, creek, etc. by the developer of a special township project in Maharashtra is, and the options are A 70 hectares, B 60 hectares, C 50 hectares, and option D is 40 hectares. And the right answer for this question number 5 is option number D, that is 40 hectares. Next question, question number 6, which of the following is the method of demographic projects? And the options are cohort component, option B is exponential growth, option C is logistic growth, and option D is all of the above. And the right answer for this question is option number D, that is all of the above. Option A, B, and C are right. Then next, question number 7, traffic signs triangular in shapes with red border are, so options are A informatory signs, option B warning signs, option C overhead signs, and option D is mandatory signs. So that sign is option B, that is warning sign in triangular shape with red border. that is warning sign. Then question number 8, in Maharashtra, how much of a built up area for low cost housing is to be handed over to state government in lieu of concessions provided to a developer of a special township project? And the options are A 10%, B 20%, C 30%, and option D is 40%. And the right answer for this question is A, that is 10%. So our next question, question number 9, is term roadway is used for, and the options are A paved surface of a road, option B carriageway of a road, option C carriageway and shoulders of a road, and option D is row of a road, that is right of way of the road. So right answer for this question is option number C, that is carriageway and shoulder from the both side of the road, that is we called it as a roadway. So next question, question number 10, special model of urban land use planning where a city grows from several nodes rather than from one nucleus is called as, and the options are A sector, B multinuclei, C ribbon development, and option D is concentric zone. And the right answer for this question number 10 is option number B, that is multinuclei. Next question, question number 11, the urban growth theory which states that development takes place along the routes on which the movement is concentrated is called as, and the options are A circular, B sector, C nucleus, and option D is axial. And the right answer is option number D, that is axial. Then next question number 12, the Tribunal of Appeal set up for a town planning scheme in Maharashtra comprises, first is president, second arbitrator, third is two assessors, and fourth is representative of planning authority. We have to choose which is right. So options A is 1, 2 and 3, option second is 1 and 3, option C is 1, 2 and 4, and option D is 1, 2, 3 and 4, that is all of these 4. So right answer for this question is second number, that is first and third is correct, that is president and two assessors. Then next question number 13, in Maharashtra, if the planning authority fails to submit the draft town planning scheme within the permissible period specified, then option A, state government can appoint an officer to prepare and submit the draft scheme. Option B, planning authority can apply for extension of the time period. Option C, planning authority can make fresh declaration for the same scheme after stipulated time. And option D is all of the above. And the right option is option D, that is all of the above. All these option A, B and C are correct for this question, this statement. And next question, question number 14, at an intersection of a road where vehicles from converging area are forced to move around the central island in a clockwise direction is called as, and the options are A rotary intersection, B channelization, C grade separated intersection, and option D is staggered intersection. And the right answer for this question is A, that is rotary intersection. Next question, question number 15, for analyzing the cause of accidents at a particular road and identifying relationship between speed and accidents, following data is most essential. So which of these data is option A, spot speed, option B is journey speed, option C is trip generation, and option D is average annual daily traffic. So options, right option is option A, that is spot speed is required. Next question, question number 16. The neighborhood unit theory in urban planning was conceptualized by, and the options are A, Homer Hoyt, B, C A Perry, C, Patrick Yedas, and option D is Juan Thune. And the right option for this question is option number B, that is C A Perry. Next question, question number 17. Sampling method in which a homogeneous listing is done for different groups of population and then collecting a certain percentage of samples from each group is called as, and the options are A, simple random sampling, option B is stratified sampling, option C is cluster sampling, and option D is systematic sampling. And the right answer for this question is option number B, that is stratified sampling. Next question, question number 18. Central Act on effective and expeditious disposal of cases relating to environmental protection, conservation of forest and other natural resources, including enforcement of any legal right, has the title of, and that titles are option A, the Mines Act 1952, option B, Wildlife Protection Act 1972, option C is National Green Tribunal Act 2010, and option D is Industrial Development and Regulation Act 1951. And the right option is option C, that is National Green Tribunal Act 2010. Then next question, question number 19. If a contiguous area for which a town planning scheme is to be prepared lies within the jurisdiction of two separated planning authorities, then option A, state government forms a special planning authority for the scheme. Then option B is each planning authority makes its own scheme. Option C, planning authority where larger area falls is liable for making the scheme. And the option D is planning authority which serves larger population is liable for making the scheme. And the right answer for this question is option number A, that is state government forms a special planning authority for this scheme. And next question, question number 20. Which of the following governs the implementation of the town planning scheme in Maharashtra? And the options are option A, Maharashtra Housing and Area Development Act 1976. Option B is Maharashtra Municipality Act 1985. Option C, Maharashtra Regional and Town Planning Act 1966. And option D is Bombay Provincial Municipal Corporation Act 1949. And the right answer you have to comment in the comment section. So this is last question of this video, so you have to comment the answer for this question in comment section.